closed up! That's a pirate hunter!
Ship coming after us, sir! It's a brig! Their ancients are Spanish! They're all alone, sir!
Starboard cabin! Bring some of our marine war cabin!
Jesus, Addy, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
I'm not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable cause. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain.
Mary. Before she died, she asked me to do good by her. To sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
You Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye. She told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why, indeed.
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom, not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edor I met here many years ago. So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Thank you.
And once more, you have our thanks, Edward. You are welcome here.
Thank you, sir. I'll rest here for a time before setting out, if I may. How's her child?
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd not be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing and drinking and fighting.
You are a fighter, aye. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
It's all true. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his lads weren't passed out in the hold from drink. Edward. Everyone's gone, right there. Mary, Rackham, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so, rough as they were. Do you feel that too? All empty inside?
I do. Devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough, but how will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers. But Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. It might take months to find him.
Or years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, don't be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster! What's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bonny. Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads! We're sailing for Jamaica!
How does it feel to bark so loud?
I've barked louder, and to men twice as rough.
Tending. The old papery, you mean?
Among other places. And I sailed with Mary and Rackham for a time, remember?
Of course.
Mary did most of the captaining, Jack did most of the drinking.
Did Mary... Did she ever tell you who it was that fathered her child?
It was a young fella. Sailed with us on that last voyage. Poor lad was killed fighting beside us. The only man not too drunk to stand up for himself.
There was so much about her I didn't know. I called her a friend. But was I one in return?
She thought the world of you, Edward. No worries about that.
Well, that's good to hear.
The Golden Fleet of Blood. Captain Kenway.
You have something for me?
The present whereabouts of the Templar Woods Rogers. He is attending a small political function, so do it clean.
The word is King George is calling Rogers back to London.
Aye, not happy with his progress in Nassau.
Still too many pirates roaming about, from what I hear.
You'll need a disguise to fool the powderheads at this party. I suggest the visiting diplomat, Ruggero Ferraro. He's been on our list for some time.
Understood. Will you send this to England for me?
Aye. The ship leaves tomorrow.
Caroline Scott Kenway, Hawkins Lane, Bristol.
Drink rum more than once a month. Mio Dio, it's revolting.
Salve. Forgive the lateness of my arrival. I am Ruggero Ferraro.
Aye, Mr. Ferraro.
Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to my brief tenure as Governor of the Bahamas. For under my watch, no less than 300 avowed pirates took the king's pardon and swore fealty to the crown. And yet, for all my successes, His Majesty has seen fit to sack me. And call me home to England.
Brilliant! God bless.
that's the fucker! Therefore, hooray! Hooray for the ignoble and ignorant pricks who rule the world with sticks up their asses!
You are hooray. Mr. Ferraro, I think.
Good day, friend.
I do
carry
adore
on.
You, such elegance.
Torres was a governor too, and
I
like
see,
me,
that's a smart looking outfit. But it can't be comfortable in this heat.
See, but for a man of a good taste as ourselves, form must always take precedence over function.
We've been lounging about the place, contemptuously bearing knives and leaving that as.
Pardon.
And
another
who is Mrs. Rogers these days?
I haven't the faith.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Thank you for hosting my little send-offs. I have been too rambunctious.
To be hanged for?
Why then, Hazard? Soon, all the monarchies of the world will come. And when that day comes, men like Torres and myself will reveal ourselves as the architects of their undoing.
Oh, Christ, Rogers! You're a bold one!
The bastards came back and took what little we've got.
I say, that's a smart-looking outfit, but it can't be comfortable in this heat.
See, but for a man of a good taste as ourselves, form must always take precedence over. I haven't the faintest idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We separated almost 5 years ago, and both our lives have been the better for it.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later, when the remainder of my reason has left.
Your lechery shames you, sir.
Idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We separated almost 5 years ago, and both our lives have been the better for it.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later, when the remainder of my reason has left.
And how is Mrs. Rogers these days?
I haven't the faintest idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We separated almost 5 years ago, and both our lives have been the better for it.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later, when the remainder of my reason has left.
Hello.
Deal by any means. When the king hears my complaints, I'm sure he'll come to a more sensible conclusion.
These days.
I haven't the faintest idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We've been breaking all the fire to you, so I hope our lives have been
effective.
Forgive
my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later, when the remainder of my reason has left.
Any regrets, Captain Rogers? Any business left unfinished?
Yes. That I paid for Nassar's restoration with my own money. Fully three-fourths of the improvements...
He was a privateer once. How is it you lack so much respect for sailors only trying to make their way in this world?
You couldn't possibly understand my motives, cretin! You have spent a whole lifetime dismantling everything that makes our civilization shine.
But I do understand. I've seen the observatory, and I know its power. You'd use that device to spy and blackmail and sabotage.
Yes. And yet all for a greater purpose. To ensure justice. To snuff out lies and to seek truth.
There's no man on Earth who needs that power.
Yet you suffer the outlaw Roberts to use it.
No. I'm taking it back. And if you tell me where he is, I'll stop the man.
Here at the edge of a blade, I find a friend in you at last. Principe. You mad bastard. Our best sources say Principe.
Shite! Of all the bad days! What's happened? Is Captain Rogers hurt?
Is it a revolt? What's happened?
It's done.
Where now?
Grab your kit and pack well. We're sailing for Africa.
Finally, I think.